Hello everyone, let's go again for another thing, and this is using WHAM from Google Colab. Let's take a look here. You can find the project page for WHAM, and here you got the link I opened. Oh, this chick is crazy, sorry for that. Let's open on another tab and you have to connect to a GPU machine or else it won't work. Oh, you probably are gonna hear a lot of this chicken noises. They're getting up right now. Okay, so we have a T4 instance and let's check the system, execute anyway. This is the official Colab. Okay, it ran. We have a Tesla T4. Go. Let's move all along. And you keep firing all the execution boxes that you find. And I'm going to be doing that and pausing when it takes longer to process, so you don't have to wait too long. The next one. This is usually a quick one. Create the environment. Done. Next, install dependencies. This one take longer. Takes longer. One more part is done, and you can watch the time that it takes. I'm cutting the seams, so you can look here to have an idea. So let's go to the next part. Done. And this one takes longer. One more part done, and to the next. Okay, now this is the important part. You have to have the login credentials. You have to register in SMPL and ESMPL file, simplify. And you have to run, and it will ask for your user and password. I'm gonna pause so it doesn't show my password. So after adding, it's going to download and extract the files needed. Okay, next part. Let's run one on demo videos. And here is the tricky thing. Not tricky. You have this command to execute, but to have the PKL files to be able to import in Blender, you have to add save PKL so it creates the file needed. Let's run it. It says 15 minutes, but it's not that long. Yeah, I had an error because I didn't use the correct password on the previous part. So let's run it again. Here's a tiny part of the process that it's doing. I'm gonna pause until it's done. And we're off to the end. Now it starts rendering the results, but while it is rendering, we already can see what we have. You can find the important data inside output, WHAM output, demo, and the name of the file that you used. In this case, it's the image 9732. Inside it, we'll have all these files. It's rendering this output.mp4, but what we need is WHAM output.pkl. You can press on this button on the side and choose download. And it's preparing the file, you can see here, so we can download it. And let me choose a place to save it. And let me put a name. It's image 9. Okay. Here it is, saved. Let's go to Blender. We can go there. And what you have to do, you load the file that I attached on my Patreon post. And you will have to install WHAM in case you didn't have, because WHAM doesn't come with Blender. You can take a look here, you press play, and it will show that it's installing. In my case, it's already installed, so I can go to the other script. And I have to go to my folder where I have the PKL file downloaded. I can get the place. On my Windows, I have a button that already gives me the path, but you can copy the path and add the name to be able to use it. Okay, so let's put it here and execute. Oh yeah, you have to download this basic model. The basic model you can get from SMPL download. You have to register. You already have the register, or else you wouldn't be able to execute the WHAM notebook. Go to downloads, and here you have download version 1.02 for Maya, and you download the SMPL file. Okay, I'm gonna download it here anyway. Then you open it and get this file, basic model M, and put on the same place that you have your your blend file. In my case, I already have it here, so it might work. So I press execute this button on top, and soon you have the animation here, but the animation comes upside down. You have to change the rotation to minus 90. Just put a minus in front of. And here you have the animation. This is the animation, the default animation, default video that the notebook has. But we can do with our own video. Let me erase this and go back to the notebook. You see here it's done. We can see the rendered video if we want. Just press this button. It might show the video it just rendered. But let's prepare another thing. While it's doing something here, let's put a video for us to execute. To do that, you have to go to the examples folder, and you have to add. Oh, it's done here. Let's just take a look. Oh, this is the original video. This one is the rendered one. We can take a look here, but we don't want it. We have it in Blender. Let me pause it. Let's go to the other place. This one is an example using a custom calibration file. Let's go to the top. This one that we just executed. Let make our own video to run using this part. Okay, let's get back. To do that, we have to upload a file. So you can go to this examples folder, press this button, and choose upload. Then you go to your system where you have your file prepared to upload. I have a couple here. Let me choose this one. And it's saying that you're gonna lose it, the file that you uploaded. Let's wait for it to upload. You can see here, down below. It's quick, it's a small video. And here it is. For sake of make it simpler, I'm gonna rename the video to Go. Just that. Okay, I changed the name and I'm gonna put its name here. It's go.mp4. And to run faster, I'm gonna remove the visualize so it won't render the result. We can have just Python demo video, our video, and save PKL. Let's run it. We can see the process is at the end. We removed the visualize option, so it will just do the feature extraction. You can see the folder already created and it is exporting the files we need. I just have to wait a little bit. And they should show up here. Maybe we have to press this update button. And here it is. Let's get this WHAM output download. And put on a new folder. Let's go back to our folder and we can get this path and put it in Blender. And let's take a look what is the video. Here I have the original video that I uploaded. It's a motion actor video from MAO and it should do this. Let's see the result. And put to minus 90. And let's go to layout to have a better view and play that. Oh, let me cut here so we can cycle. And this video is in 60 frames per second. Let me start again. And that's it. To this day, I didn't see an easier way to get a decent and cool looking animation from a single camera. Hope you enjoyed it and have lots of fun. And let me talk with this chicken that is yelling at my window. Bye.